Essence of Bhagavad Gita, Chapter 7, Jnana Vijnana Yoga. The first six chapters dealt with three broad topics: Jiva Swarupam, Karma Yoga, and the importance of individual effort. Now we move into the second portion of the Gita, which discusses Ishvara Swarupam, Upasana Yoga, and Grace of Ishvara. The first three verses introduce the topic of Ishvara. The Lord said, "Taking refuge in me and practicing yoga with a mind which is totally absorbed in me, you will come to know me completely and doubtlessly. May you listen to this, O Arjuna. I shall completely impart to you this jnana along with vijnana, gaining which knowledge nothing more remains to be known in this life." Krishna says by following his teaching, one can know me, Krishna, meaning one can know God, Ishvara. He classifies his teaching into two parts that he refers to as jnana, the knowledge of the lower nature of God, or Saguna Ishvara, and vijnana, the knowledge of God's higher nature, Nirguna Ishvara. A seeker at the Saguna Ishvara level will see difference between God and himself, like wave and ocean. A seeker at the Nirguna Ishvara level will only see water and no difference between Ishvara and the self. Jnanam is Dvaita Jnanam. Vijnanam is Advaita Jnanam. Krishna describes his eightfold lower nature called Apara Prakriti and his higher nature called Para Prakriti. He is the sole cause of the entire universe, which is just a mixture of his higher and lower nature. God's higher nature, the consciousness principle, manifesting in the universe is called Paramatma. Manifesting in the individual, it is called Jivatma. Krishna wants us to change our attitude, to see divinity everywhere and develop a reverence for everything. He stresses this in verses 8 to 12. O Arjuna, I am the taste in water. I am the radiance in the moon and sun. I am the Omkara in all the Vedas. I am the sound in space. I am the manliness in men. In verses 13 to 19, Krishna discusses the cause of samsara and its remedy. The problem is that apara prakriti or matter, due to its very nature, is constantly changing. Leaning on an inconsistent source for security is the cause of samsara. Remedy: rely on the constant para prakriti for happiness. Krishna presents the solution as surrendering to him. Krishna seems to be saying that sharanagati or bhakti is the solution. If you recall, he said in the second chapter that jnana was the solution to samsara. Isn't Krishna contradicting himself? We should remember that bhakti can be at different levels. The first level of bhakti is love of God as a means to an end. I will do this worship so I can get a benefit, like a job. The second level of bhakti is where God is not the means, but the end itself. The highest level of bhakti is through knowledge, the realization that God is not different than myself at the absolute level. Krishna clarifies that bhakti leads to jnana yoga, but cautions that this is a long process that could take many lifetimes. Krishna classifies bhakti into two categories based on motive. In verses 20 to 26, he discusses sakama bhakti, where love of God is only the means to a goal. In verses 27 to 30, Krishna says the nishkama bhakta, whose goal is God himself, transcends old age and death. He transitions to the next chapter by introducing seven factors in the final verse: Brahman, Karma, Adhyatma, the self, Adibhuta, Adideva, Adiyajna, and remembering God at the time of death. Om Tat Sat.